My name is Ariel Bolanos. I am the owner-operator of Boss & Sons, LLC, and we are a small machine shop located in Wisconsin. I've been welding since I was 12 years old. I've been machining since I was since I could stand. I got interested in machining, honestly, in my later or earlier 20s when I realized I didn't have the money to pay someone to build all the stuff for my hobby, which is my car. So I guess I learned a lot of stuff out of necessity. I found the Tormach mills after doing significant amount of research on what was out there. So I wanted to get something newer that I felt would give me the amount of hours out of it that I need. I have operated various large machines with various different controllers. So the Tormach was actually quite user friendly to, you know, get the grasp of. But the main reason we went with the 1100 was for the ATC. I felt like if I wanted to be competitive on quotes for production, even if it was small production runs, that I had to have an ATC. I think if I was just standing there babysitting it and changing the tools, I was not going to be efficient enough to be competitive in the market today. One of my favorite options on the Tormach is definitely the scan tool that allows you to take a part with a profile or hole locations and put it in the mill and then pick up the geometry based off of a series of images that are then scaled by the machine movement. From there you can draw the geometry as you need it and import it into your CAD-CAM system and work with that that image that you've created then. This is a vacuum pump impeller, a bronze vacuum pump impeller from a vacuum pump system in a large building that is pulling ventilation out of labs. It clearly broke the fin and has been worn, so we were asked if we could replicate this vacuum pump impeller. And the only way that I thought I could do it was by putting it in the mill and using the scan tool, which then gave me the geometry of the fins. After having the geometry of the fins, I was able to draw it and extrude it to have these surfaces to then generate tool paths from. One of the industries that I have been making quite a few components for is a startup company that's doing diamond coating on micro end mills. And they've been having me build the majority of their fixturing for inside their vacuum chamber. And we've had to work with, you know, everything is either stainless, Maycor, which is what they call machinable glass ceramic, or glass-filled mica, which is another ceramic. So I've been working with a large range of materials, not just your standard materials like I did at other shops.
Today, I am going to show you guys, we're making some prototype components for a DSLR shoulder rig that we've been developing with a customer.
I don't find that I have a particular niche industry at this point. I can make almost anything, and if someone provides me with a print that I feel I can't, I'll be the first one to tell them that. Yeah, the ultimate goal for Boss & Sons is, I think, for me to be able to have a crew of guys that I can trust and have a clientele base that needs parts in a timely manner that I can supply them.